Hello and welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to talk about Rush Hour and why this movie was so great when it comes down to representation and character development. Let's get to it.
Do you understand the words that are coming out of my mouth?
The movie begins in China where you get introduced to the first main protagonist, Detective Lee, played by Jackie Chan, as he stops illegal smuggling of ancient Chinese artifacts using his martial arts mastery and his acrobatic prowess. Lee's character is devoted in his occupation in law enforcement. He has a calm, dependable, and selfless personality. The second main protagonist, Detective Carter, played by Chris Tucker, is introduced as an undercover cop in the LAPD. His cover gets blown during a sting and he shoots a runaway car filled with C4. He even does a Michael Jackson routine after he blows up the car. There are other support characters that have great character development, and I'll address them later in this video. The main plot of this movie is introduced early in the movie when the US-Chinese ambassador's daughter gets kidnapped after they move to the US. Detective Lee flies to the US in order to find the kidnapped daughter. The FBI puts Detective Carter in charge of keeping Detective Lee away from the case, and both Lee and Carter develop a bond with a common goal of saving Soo Young. It's a basic cop story. The beauty of the movie is how they did representation without making it feel like a Hollywood or a social political agenda. Don't get me wrong, race played a huge part in the movie, but the race of the characters were never outwardly mentioned, nor was it used as a plot-driving device. Race was instead used to drive a humorous tone, and a tool used for character development instead of an obstacle to overcome. The difference in each character's race was embraced. There are a few scenes in this movie that displayed a clash of culture better than others. Going in chronological order, the first scene where the FBI tells the Chinese consulate they have their best men working on the case, and the father responds back saying he's not American, nor is his daughter. The father flies Lee from China in order to help work on this case because that's someone he trusts. The FBI is against working with a foreign national and eventually gets an LAPD officer in order to keep Lee away from the case. Carter was chosen as the person to watch over Lee as a punishment from blowing up the car earlier in the movie. This scene shows a lack of trust that the father has with the US law enforcement, the lack of willingness the FBI has to work with someone from a different nation, and Carter's department with his ability to properly perform his duties. The race of these characters are subtly implied in these scenes, but they were not openly addressed and not the focal point of the video. The second scene is when Carter and Lee meets for the very first time. This has got to be one of the most memorable scenes of the movie. Carter meets Lee at the airport and after a short dialogue, assumes that Lee can't speak or understands English.
I'm Detective Carter. Do you speak any English? Do you understand the words that are coming out of my mouth?
Lee knows how to speak English, but he decides to stay silent. The third scene is when Carter and Lee goes to Chinatown to get more information about the missing daughter. A Jackie Chan-esque pursuit begins between Carter and Lee, and after they get together again, Carter tells Lee that the FBI doesn't want Lee's help. Lee doesn't understand why the FBI doesn't want his help. While chatting in the car, Lee eventually turns on a radio in order to shut up Carter. A song from the Beach Boys came on where Lee was aware of who the Beach Boys are and actually enjoyed the music. Carter then changes the music and eventually plays hip-hop music by Jay-Z and Ja Rule. Music that Lee is unfamiliar with. Yo, this movie has a lot of hits, by the way. They eventually make their way to a pool hall to get more information about the missing child, and you find out that Carter's cousin actually owns that establishment, and the cousin's doing a few illegal things that Carter decides to overlook. This is another one of the most iconic scenes in the movie. They both enter the pool hall, and Carter greets other black people using the N-word. Because Lee isn't familiar with US Ebonics, he assumes that using the N-word is a nice way to introduce himself to someone new. Lee casually introduces himself to the black bartender using the N-word, and a fight begins between Lee and the bartender and a few other people at the pool hall.
What's up, man? What did you just say? What's up, my name?
This next scene goes over how difficult it was for Carter and Lee to work together for the very first time. The FBI falls into a trap, leading Lee and Carter into a chase with one of the villains. This scene shows a lack of chemistry between both main protagonists. And there are three examples from the scene I want to point out. The first example was when Carter didn't support Lee when he went up to the FBI's telling them they're going into a trap. The second scene is during a chase when Lee didn't lower a ladder low enough so that Carter can properly climb up and chase after the villain. The third example is when Carter didn't stop when Lee told him to stop moving due to a weak scaffolding that they eventually fall through. This stream demonstrated their inability to work together as they had different motives and they didn't trust each other. The next scene is when they start bonding and start accepting each other's differences. Carter and Lee receive a tip about the location of the villain and eventually stakes out a restaurant. A few examples of them bonding is first, Lee teaching Carter how to disarm a gun at gunpoint, Carter teaching Lee ebonics and dance moves, and lastly, a hilarious conversation about both of their dads. This scene isn't only pivotal due to their character development, but also because of how they embrace cultural differences. And this scene felt like a real interaction between two regular human beings. Lee had an open mind learning ebonics and dance moves. Carter was hesitant at first to try new Chinese food, but he eventually loved it. But the most important part about this scene is that they end up disagreeing about whose father was better.
My daddy wants to arrest 15 people in one night by himself.
My daddy arrests 25 by himself.
My daddy saved 5 crackheads from a burning building by himself.
My daddy once caught a bullet with his bare hands.
My daddy would kick your daddy's ass all the way from here to China, Japan, wherever the hell you're from, and all up that Great Wall,
hey,
too.
Don't talk about my father.
Don't talk about my daddy.
Representation is more than just being agreeable. It's about acknowledging cultural differences. The next scene I want to go over is when they start working together. Carter and Lee gets into a fight with the villain and his henchmen again, but this time it's a little different. They eventually learn how to work together and escape. This is also the lowest point in character development. This location is where the ransom transaction is supposed to take place, and Lee and Carter screwed it up. Lee failed his mission of saving Soo Young, going against his dependable character trait established early in the movie. Carter, on the other hand, overcame his selfishness by continuing to work on the mission without the approval of the FBI, and eventually convinced Lee to do the same. The last scene I want to talk about is the climax of the movie. Both protagonists work flawlessly together, eventually ends up saving the daughter and stopping the villain. Lee was able to redeem himself by being able to save the daughter, whereas Carter was involved in something greater than himself. As noted earlier in this video, representation and character development didn't just stop with the two main protagonists. There are a few support characters that had their own character arc. The first support character is the father. The father was great for representation because he held a high socioeconomic title, but he was just a worried father in this movie. His race or his title didn't overshadow the fact that he was just a worried father trying to get his daughter back. Cast member number two, the daughter, Soo Young. Soo Young was just a kid in this movie. There was no mention of her even being aware of her race. She told her Uncle Lee that she would miss him when she moved to the States. She sang loudly and proudly Mariah Carey in the car. And she took bluffing a little too far when she told the villains to just press the button.
Push the button.
What are you doing?
I'm just playing, play along. Come on, push the button.
Yeah, come on, push your button.
Blow everybody up.
Yeah, blow everybody up.
Push the goddamn button.
Push the goddamn button.
You heard what she said.
Again, her race didn't play a part in her character. Supporting cast number three, who's great for women empowerment, is Detective Johnson. In the beginning of the movie, it was established that Detective Johnson was supposed to be Detective Carter's partner. Her gender was never mentioned in this movie. Do you know why? It's because everyone in this movie treated her as an equal. The only person that made any comment about her gender in this movie is Detective Carter, and it was just playful banter. Her first scene showed her as a boss lady. She was in the office, wearing a suit, bantering with her male colleagues. Later, you see a scene of her dancing home alone, having a great time. Lastly, in the final scene, she's wearing a dress and kicking ass. Not only is Detective Johnson great for representation, she also had her own character development. Midway through the movie, you see her fail a bomb defusing test. You see her character growth at the end of the movie when she defuses the bombs attached to Soo Young. And the best thing about this scene is that Detective Johnson was unsure of herself. She wasn't sure which wire to cut, but she still had to make a decision because she knew that their lives depended on it. To conclude this video, Rush Hour did a phenomenal job with cultural representation and using it as a way to develop and nurture character development. I also believe that the US and Chinese culture were both well represented. Rush Hour is such a great movie. Thank you for making it to the end of this video. If you like it, please leave a like, comment, or subscribe. And I plan on making a lot of content like this. Since this is the end of the video, here's a little fun fact. Chris Tucker made 4 racial Asian jokes in the first 4 minutes of the movie when Carter and Lee meets for the first time. And I think the best scene of the movie is when Soo Young sings in a car. It's such a thing a little kid could do. All right, thank you. Bye.